Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So, on the agenda tonight, we have Mark Farner, of course, with Grand Funk Railroad, and this is coming from 1974, and they're going to be playing through Heartbreaker. So let's get Mark and the guys up on screen and see how they get on. I'm just going to jump in here because this one is going to be a tough one to stop because I just want to listen to it the whole way through. And it's interesting that I did a video last night on Vandenberg playing in the 80s, and I mentioned how bands just plugged in and played, and you got a really close sound to the album track to the record when they played live. And this is going back to 1974, so 10 years earlier. And these kind of guys really did pave the way for the guys that came later because, of course, the kids growing up, going to watch these guys live and even watching them on TV, it set the bar as to where bands had to be in order to compete with the quality that was around at the time. But the amount of talent that was around at these times and even the decades before as well just absolutely had the art down of being able to perform live and nail it live. But just putting the spotlight back on Mark here for a second, because Mark was one of those really rare things that I always mention about guitarists who can also sing as well. I always say it doubles the difficulty playing and singing at the same time. But Mark is in that really select group that actually have got a great vocal, and it could be a lead vocal just on its own, but then he's supplying the rhythm and lead guitar as well. If you imagine the other bands that were around at the time, generally they would have a guitarist who was very well known, and then they had a designated singer. But guys in that kind of setup in the 70s and especially in the 80s, at best were just supplying backing vocals, and then they might take center stage for their lead guitar solo, and then they'll drop back again for when the singer comes back in, that designated singer. Whereas here we've got this with Mark, that he can take center stage, supply that vocal, and then break off into a lead solo and come back and supply that lead vocal. Such a rare thing, especially to have this kind of vocal quality and vocal ability. You can imagine him just strutting around the stage here just with a microphone because the vocal's that strong, but then he's also got the ability on the instrument to then take you on a journey with his lead solo, which we'll be getting into later. Hopefully I'm going to be able to watch the majority of this video because just the whole band are absolutely on it. I just want to mention quickly Don Brewer, who who's playing drums here, supplying those backing vocals at the same time as playing, but also the fact that he hasn't got a double foot pedal here. It's just all with that right leg, even though it sounds in sections like he has, because he's throwing it in there, but he's just doing all of that work with the right leg on that bass drum. So it's really cool to listen to, especially when you just watch his leg going and the way that he's so solid with it, not only the drumming, but the backing vocals as well. Absolutely spot on. But let's get back into the performance. Going to jump in here again just to point out, and hopefully you have got an appreciation of the journey that's going on here, the way that we've been changing dynamics the whole way through the track, and those great stops that we have where the band has got to be so tight in order to pull that off live, and getting into Mark's solo because he's got a great bluesy way of playing, throwing together lines, throwing in that vibrato as well. It's one of those things I mention all the time, but it's great when a player throws in that vibrato and doesn't let notes hang, but gets to express with every note. And when you know that Mark wrote most of the material as well, he's got that ear for melody and composition, as well as having that great voice and being able to play that kind of solo, melt your face if he wants to. He's just literally everything that you want in one musician. Obviously, when you're playing in a band and playing live, you need to rely on other guys. And of course, the rest of the band are absolutely spot on here. And while I'm on that subject, quick shout out to Mel Shucker as well, who's absolutely locked in with Don on drums. That foundation has to be absolutely solid for everything else to be laid on top of. Let's get back into it. And there we go. What a tight ending that was. But what a great performance in general, and just the journey that they take you on. I always say this about the top bands, is that when they play live and when they actually get the tracks down and actually compose, each song is always going to be a journey. And for anybody out there who's noticing these time signatures that we've got going on here, 3 time to start with and then back to 4 time at the end. And just to quickly explain that, 3-4 timing, it's a time signature where you count to 3. You go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And the beginning of your bar is always obviously on 1, but you're only going to 3, whereas normally in 4-4 timing, you go to 4. And that's what they had at the end there, just a really straight shift to 4-4. And it's one of those things that obviously is really intentionally put in there when it's being written. And if anything, it makes it really stand out, having that 3-4 timing, because it's almost like a ballad song when we start out, but then getting into that groove of the 3-4 really makes it up-tempo. And then we change into the 4-4 at the end, just absolutely rock out. And the band's so tight throughout the whole performance, but also in that last section, is so well rehearsed, so well got down, all on the same page. And let me just point out that Mark is not one of these players that's just going to sing and play guitar and just stand still. He's got that entertainment side as well, that showmanship. And you could argue that the amount that he's already doing, it could be forgiven for just standing there, concentrating on the vocal, concentrating on your lead guitar, concentrating on your rhythm. But he absolutely puts the showmanship into it as well. And also with what he wears and what he's wearing in this particular performance, obviously 1974, this kind of thing was all the rage, but it's just that whole showmanship side that a lot of players miss out on. There's so many impressive elements about this performance that I just wanted to play it the whole way through. I'm not going to have time to get into the background of Grand Funk, but just so you know, quickly, Mark supplied the lead vocal and lead guitar and rhythm work until about 1976, so a couple of years after this video, and then came back for a couple of years at the beginning of the 80s, and then in the late 90s came back for a couple of years again. I don't really know the reasons for him coming in and out. I think it's just band politics, like it always tends to be. But when he is that talisman of the band, what a guy to have at the front of your stage, not only for that lead guitar, but for that voice. Absolutely epic vocals that he can lay down, so effortless and just all over it. He's got that bluesy, soulful sound to it as well. But thank you so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!